He was the middle-aged enthusiastic enthusiast, a photography supply store clerk and amateur snapper who captured the Harbour Bridge as it grew from stumps to span.
In exactly the same work environment as the workers themselves.
Absolutely, and that's what's so wonderful about this documentation is that he was all over the bridge.
Henry Mallard would spend 4 years clambering over construction as the bridge took form, taking the same risks as those who worked it, not a fluoro vest or safety line in sight.
He is in the same situation as these men.
Absolutely, precariously positioned in amongst the workers. It's very extraordinary.
Lugging both heavy still and motion picture cameras to deadly heights, Mallard framed what are sometimes the smudges of men against the giant steel.
He liked to use silhouette to show off figures, and definitely that's they've become a part of the structure. You know, they build it, they breathe it, they are the structure. There's 6 million rivets in the bridge, and this is a perfect example of Mallard being there at the moment of creation.
Mallard would strike for whatever platform would give him the best frame.
But you still get this great sense of height and of the view from the top of the bridge.
Which makes me wonder where he took the shot from.
Well, it would have been one of the cranes that was picking up the different beams from the barges below.
Yet his sense of art also translates to the surface of the harbour as barges toting steel battled swell.
Over a period of 8 years of building the bridge, of course, every day wasn't going to be perfect.
A selection of Mallard's work is now on show at the Liverpool Regional Museum, an area undergoing its own major infrastructure build at Badgerys Creek.
That's exactly what the Sydney Harbour Bridge was back in the 20s and 30s.
And remarkably, hundreds of his negatives of the time would lay in a trunk stored in a backyard shed until discovered by his son in 1975. Mike Dalton, Nine News.